Hello, my name is Dr. David Allen. I'm a retired cardiac surgeon and a member of the International Cannabinoid Research Society, ICRS. That means I'm a cannabinoid research scientist. And I'm here to tell you about the discovery of the endocannabinoid system, the ECS, and the significance and how it will change medicine. And we discovered the endocannabinoid system about 30 years ago, and we really didn't understand the significance of its discovery. And so we found out that this is a chemical communication that your body has. It's not electrical, it's chemical, and it's kind of like the hormone systems that people are familiar with. And your body makes these cannabinoids. They're endogenous, so they're endocannabinoids, and they perform some miraculous functions in the body. And we're just learning the significance of these functions. And basically, the endocannabinoid system is responsible for homeostasis. Most people don't understand what that really means, but it's the body's ability to maintain itself and function in the proper environment. And so it's critically important that that doctors in the future understand this control mechanism. And we're finding out that that manipulation of this endocannabinoid system will control diabetes, it controls cancer, it controls whether you can survive a heart attack or stroke. And so this is critically important for doctors to understand this new science. And the discovery of the endocannabinoid system is the single most important medical scientific discovery ever, and will save more lives than the discovery and application of sterile surgical technique. And I'm a heart surgeon saying that. So more people will be saved by manipulation of the endocannabinoid system than are currently saved by surgery.
But recent research has been looking at cannabis and the different cannabinoids. There's over 80 plus cannabinoids discovered in the cannabis plant. The second most dominant one besides THC is cannabidiol or CBD. Okay. And the research now is over 1,200 peer-reviewed journals on CBD. It's probably the most exciting and researched ingredient or substance right now around the world. Mm-hmm. It doesn't have the psychoactive or high that is associated with THC, but it has a tremendous amount of other benefits, including research shows anti-seizure, anti-epileptic, which is why it's gotten a lot of popularity. You deal a lot with children with seizure disorders, and they're getting benefits from this plant in a safe, non-toxic way versus all these drugs that typically don't work. Mm-hmm. And there's neuroprotective benefits, so you see a lot with concussions and the NFL. There's a lot of research being done now with chronic traumatic encephalopathy, or chronically banging your head a lot. There's anti-anxiety, which is really important. It's the anti-THC of sorts. It calms you down. It helps you manage stress better, which is how I look at it. It's much more as a preventative or daily use substance than just treating disease states. And there's immune support. There's it's a huge antioxidant. There's just a tremendous, it's easier sometimes to talk about what it doesn't do than what it does.
Dr. Alan Shackelford is a Harvard-trained physician. He's also among a handful of doctors in Colorado who give prescriptions for medical marijuana. From the moment Charlotte entered his office, he knew she was in trouble. While he was just examining her, she had two seizures.
She'd failed everything. There were no more options for her. Everything had been tried, except cannabis.
Here's how scientists think it might work. Marijuana is made up of two ingredients, THC, that's the psychoactive part that makes you high, and CBD, also called cannabidiol. It's the CBD that scientists think modulates electrical and chemical activity to help quiet the excessive activity in the brain that causes seizures.
I've been telling my patients to cut.
Dr. Julie Holland is the editor of The Pot Book, a complete guide to cannabis.
For a long time, the work on cannabis and epilepsy was sort of inconclusive. Maybe it works, maybe it doesn't. They couldn't quite figure it out. And it's only when they really started separating THC from CBD that they saw, you know, definitively, yes, CBD seems to really stop seizures.
What is it about hemp that's so controversial? Why is it always in the news lately? And is it only because it's tied to medical marijuana? Can it be good? I'll leave the legal discussion to the lawyers. What I'm interested in are potential health benefits. You know, hemp, cannabis, that plant that can be legally grown all over the world and is often used in marijuana production. With all this news, I decided to do a little digging and to try to figure out why hemp is so controversial. I mean, hard liquor is legal and it has no redeeming health qualities whatsoever. So does hemp have any redeeming qualities? We'll find out. With us is the author of Cancer, Step Outside the Box, Ty Bollinger. Hi, Ty. Thanks for being with us.
Thank you, Carol.
One of the really incredible things I was reading about in your book was hemp.
Yeah.
Marijuana, basically.
Right.
Tell us the history of hemp, because I found this quite unusual.
Well, hemp has the reputation as being this evil weed. But the medicinal history of hemp is quite fascinating. Back as far back as the 1930s, there were medicinal hemp tinctures in almost every pharmacy in the United States.
Hang on, I want to go even further back.
Yeah.
Didn't you write in your book that Washington and Jefferson and Lincoln and all these presidents actually grew hemp, so it was legal to grow everywhere?
They did.
And they could use it as they wanted to use it.
Yes, as a matter of fact, some farmers in the colony of Virginia were required to grow hemp. And so it's such a good fiber. Very good for making clothes, a lot of different industrial uses for hemp.
Ford thought it was strong enough to make a car out of it, and he did.
One
it
of
was as strong as steel.
Yeah, one of the first Model Ts was actually made from hemp, and it ran on hemp fuel.
And then the enemy of hemp was William Randolph Hearst.
With paper. Well, yeah,
Explain that.
Well, hemp is a much more efficient way to make paper. In 1 acre of hemp, you can do 10 times the amount of paper than 1 acre of trees.
So why did he want it outlawed?
Because he owned thousands of acres of forest that when he owned paper.
So this was a political thing. It had really nothing to do with hemp itself.
Exactly. It really didn't. It was more about the money. It was more about eliminating the competition. And so that's why hemp was demonized and thought of as this evil weed. They put out propaganda films like Reefer Madness and so forth to make people afraid of hemp. When in reality, that's one small use of hemp, the recreational use, which is called, we call it marijuana.
Marijuana.
But that was a slang term that they developed to make people afraid of it.
Oh, heck, Mary Jane, doobies, everything.
Exactly.
I mean, they've got a lot of slang terms for it. So in the 1930s, they made tinctures. What were they making the tinctures for, and why were they doing these tinctures?
Well, I mean, the medicinal uses of hemp are just numerous. The hemp helps, well, we can talk about the cancer effects of hemp, but it helps with inflammation. It's very anti-inflammatory. It helps with seizures. It's very effective with PTSD for the vets that are coming back that have post-traumatic traumatic stress disorder.
Mm-hmm.
Very effective at treating that. It's an anti-inflammatory. But then the uses of hemp for cancer, what I've studied, because of my book, Cancer, Step Outside the Box, and the number of cancers, there's about a dozen different cancers that have been studied in depth with medicinal marijuana, with hemp. And so the studies from brain cancer to prostate cancer to pancreatic cancer, uterine cancer, cervical cancer, prostate cancer, it's amazing.
Okay, so what is in hemp?
Yeah.
That it's this THC, correct?
Well, there's chemicals that are called cannabinoids.
Right.
THC is short for delta-9 tetrahydrocannabinol.
I'm glad you said it, because I couldn't.
That's the only time I'll get it right. I'm glad I got it right. So that's the one, THC is the one cannabinoid that everyone's familiar with. That's
right.
The one that's psychoactive, and that's the one that gets you high if you smoke it.
Okay.
But there's other cannabinoids. One is called CBD, cannabidiol, and it's very medicinally used. There's no psychoactive component of CBD.
So what do they do, extract these? They make tinctures?
Yeah, they
or
make
you can
tinctures.
Make tea out of?
You can make tea. You can eat it. It's a great superfood. You're into raw. A lot of people use raw hemp in their superfood.
Do you get high off of hemp if you eat it as a superfood?
No. Well,
or just the seeds?
You've got to heat the THC to make it become psychoactive. So people that eat the plant, they put in a smoothie, you know, the super green smoothies.
Right.
You're not going to get high off of that because you didn't superheat it.
But is it then, if you put it in a smoothie like that, is it good prevention to cancer?
It is. It's very, well, it's got a perfect ratio of omega-3 to 6 fatty acids. It's got more GLA, gamma-linolenic acid, than any other plant. So it's got some really great fats. You're well aware of the importance of good fats in your diet.
Yeah.
So hemp it's a perfect superfood to eat. But it's also medicinal.
I just never understood why hemp had gotten such a bad rap, and now I understand that it was really politically motivated by somebody who owned basically trees and didn't want to be in competition with the hemp to make paper. And yet, throughout the years after that, so many people suffered because of that.
Yeah.
So I guess it's actually a good thing that people are coming around a little bit.
It is. I'm really encouraged about the different legislation in different states that are trying to legalize medicinal hemp because of the fact that it is so good. It's not just a superfood. It's not just great for industrial uses, as we've mentioned, but it's a really good medicine.
Thank you so much for coming on, Ty. I really appreciate you being here.
Thank you, Carol. Appreciate it.